just remembering our parents also graded the doors. They were wonderful parents. And also Claudia Cooper. In memory of the best friend Angie had in the world. And also Miller and Nadia Flaherty, our grandparents. He was remembering his mom, Velma. Lynn. Lynn is remembering her daddy, James Percy Strong. Also her mother, Lucy Strong. Remembering her mother, Miss Julia Devitt, today. She says that she misses her very much. Miss Linda. Linda's remembering her uncle, Bob Watson, this morning. And also a good friend, Claudia. And she's lighting one for Mike in memory of his mother, Miss Julia Devitt. Kevin's got a lot more of his and Jason's. I was remembering my mom and daddy. They were the finest example of Christian parents. They were my heroes and my best friends. And also, my grandparents, Millard and Audie Flaherty. They were wonderful grandparents and they adored their family. Milton and Beatrice Sherry are my other grandparents. They were devoted Christians. They taught us all the meaning of living a good Christian life. And also my Uncle Terry Flaherty. He was extremely intelligent, loving, and generous. And he always helped the less fortunate. Also my great-grandmother, whom I never met, but was named after her, Sally Sherrier. She was a charter member of this church and a devoted Christian, and I'm honored to be named after her. And also Uncle Joe Ray Bovell. He was my cousin and my uncle both. He proudly served his country in the Navy. He was loving and he was funny, and I'm honored to be named after him also. Just forgive me.
In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world, and everyone went to his own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them,
"Do not be afraid. I bring you good news, a great joy that will be for all people. Today in town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord."
Suddenly, a great company of heavenly hosts appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men whom his favor rests." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby, who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them.